I actually got the idea of investigating the anti-icing properties of polar bear fur from watching a television program, which was called something like Who Knows Stuff Like That. And in this television program, I learned that polar bears, when you observe them in the Arctic through an infrared camera, are essentially invisible because they're so well insulated that the fur has exactly the same temperature as the surrounding. In my daily life as a scientist, I have been doing work on the anti-icing properties of materials. So I was immediately fascinated by this because I also know that polar bears jump into water to hunt. So this just triggered these thoughts in me that I was thinking, how is this possible? Right? How, because you would expect then when they come up of the water that, you know, they would start to accumulate ice on the fur. Why does this not happen? And I thought, this I want to find out. And then I called my colleagues at the Polar Institute in Tromsø. And the great thing is, when you mention the word polar bear, people immediately say, yes, we want to help. And at the same time, I visited the National Museum of Denmark. I originally come from Denmark, and so I knew from my childhood that they had a very big collection of objects from Greenland, and that many of them were made with polar bear fur. There I realized already that polar bear fur has a very low friction. And I learned how the Inuits used polar bear fur specifically for hunting. The Inuits are really mimicking the polar bear hunting strategy, and they will even use hunting stools which have been shot with the polar bear fur. Behavioral biologists have in the last decade or so described that polar bears do most of the hunting as breathing hole hunts, lying still, and then when a seal comes, they will slide into the water. So they need to do very silent, quick sliding. And they also need, when they sit at the breeding hole, to be very, very silent because seals have very good hearing. And of course, very good sliding means very low friction. It's like, you know, when you have a creaching door and you add the oil and then it doesn't creach anymore. It's the same with this grease on the polar bear fur. It basically allows the polar bear to lie very, very still. And the Inuit do exactly the same. And a sort of last step, they even put slippers under their boots, which are polar bear fur. So they really sit when they do this breathing hole hunting. With the whole contact area is just polar bear fur to minimize noise reduction. I'm glad we also managed to make that a part of the paper to highlight these amazing insights. So we had all these fascinating indications, but we still needed to figure out what was actually causing this. And I was sort of, as a physicist, initially hoping it would be just the structure of the hair, but it's not. We realized quite quickly that it's a hair grease. And Julian Carolan, the PhD student from Trinity in Ireland, was working on the project. So Julian did a lot of very systematic experiments where he basically took blocks of ice and made them slide on the polar bear fur. And we also, for comparison, we investigated ski fur from Åsnes ski factory. And they gave me some of the fur that you put under cross-country skis. And then we discovered to our amazement that polar bear fur has anti-icing, so sliding properties, which are equivalent to the best racing ski fur that you can get. So I then contacted my colleague Øyvind Halskov here at the University of Bergen, the biosciences, to analyze the hair grease and found particular compounds that we thought were likely to be responsible for the anti-icing. Then we contacted some quantum chemists who confirmed that these compounds had particularly low anti-icing properties. And so we have now moved on to basically file a patent, and based on these compounds, which we can produce synthetically. And so then the aim is maybe we'll one day have a new polar bear inspired ski wax, which is environmentally friendly.